Hi guys! Today I'm going to show how you can easily watch playlists of remote MKV movie and TV show links in M3U files from sites like Fluxus TV or Pastebin.com on your Apple TV. Apple TV 4 has the Player Xtreme app natively, but the AirPlay iOS version has Autoplay, allowing you to sit back and watch every episode of your favorite TV show, as well as being able to easily select any episode. Here is an M3U file with different MKV links of different shows. As you can see, I'm able to watch these MKV M3U links on my Apple TV. This setup requires a PC NAS drive and the Player Xtreme Pro iOS app. If you are also interested in knowing how to stream your PC's desktop with audio and video to your Apple TV using any version of Windows, then subscribe to be notified when I post. So let's get started. First, you will need a local M3U file with video links only. I will be posting a future video on how to retrieve links and create your own custom M3U playlist files from TV and movie sites. In this M3U file, I have FLV, AVI, and MKV video links. In order to cast the videos contained in this M3U file, each individual video must be copied to a M3U 8 file to be accessible by the Player Xtreme iOS app. I've created a YTXplay M3U utility to do this. There will be a link to this utility in the description box below. You will need to unzip and place it into a NAS folder accessible by the Player Xtreme app. Here are the utility's M3U file requirements. First, you must delete the M3U header row, which is hashtag EXTM3U. Second, scan through the M3U file and remove any blank rows. Third, the M3U file should only contain video links, no TS links or M3U 8 links, etc. Fourth, each video should only have two rows, the header hashtag EXTINF row and the actual link row. Fifth, the hashtag EXTINF row should end with the video's title name after a double quote, then a comma, because the tool scans the file and picks up that information. Sixth, prior to the video's title name, as mentioned, there must be a double quote, then a comma, and nothing other than the video's title's alphanumeric characters, meaning you cannot have special characters like a greater than or less than sign, brackets, etc., as part of a video title name. If you do have special characters, you will need to do a search and replace to set the special character to either null or a blank space. Now, you just need to copy and paste your revised M3U file into the M3U input.m3u file. Before you can run the tool, you will need to do a one-time update in the run ccoutm3u.bat file and update it with the current folder the run ccoutm3u.bat file will be running from in the CURRDIR variable. Once again, the CURRDIR variable, which stands for current directory, and save the change. Next, run the run ccoutm3u.bat file from the YTXplay M3U folder. The generated M3U files will be located in the YTXplay M3U / M3U out folder. Finally, you just need to navigate to that NAS folder from the Player Xtreme app and select from those M3U files. In this demo, I'm streaming an AVI, FLV, and MKV video to my Apple TV. And as mentioned, this is an Autoplay M3U playlist. Now, FYI, this utility will delete the previously generated M3U8 files during its next run. So if you want to keep your M3U8 files for future use, you should copy them to a different NAS folder.
Hey guys. So if you found this video helpful, then give it a big thumbs up and subscribe.
Thanks for watching.